While discussing vowels and vowel-like articulatory gestures, we talked about the American vowels, and we also discussed the British vowels. But the possibility is that since English has got so many varieties, we must also be able to talk about the vowels which are found in various accents of English. So that's an important discussion. And we should be able to explore the various accents of English in terms of vowels, right? Like how vowels are different in various varieties of English. And then how can we develop that difference is a point of discussion. And then how can we think about the differences, the contrasts, and the similarities in the varieties of English, right? So the point is that we should have very common reference points, right? And the reference points should be known to everyone who is in the loop of discussion, right? So the most commonly used reference is, which is used in phonetics, is the cardinal vowels, right? We have been discussing, you may know about the primary cardinal vowel system and the secondary cardinal vowel system. But we can also think about some other, features, which are the points of common reference. Like the one is that the American English, right? So American English is a reference which can be applied across various varieties of English which is spoken in America, right? Or the American continent, okay? So American English can also be one reference point, which is common to both the describer and the person who is reading or who is listening, right? So one feature is like the R coloring of American English is a feature which is understandable to any person who knows American English, right? So that R coloring is a point which can be used for discussing various features of the varieties of English spoken in America, right? And you can think about some other, common references. Like when you are teaching to the students, right? And they know about one common language, right? Like in a Pakistani context, when you want to explain a vowel, you can use examples from Urdu, right? Or you can use, if your mother tongue is the same, you can use that mother tongue as a reference that, okay, this sound is typically pronounced in our mother tongue. So these are the common references which can be used, and we can plot them on the chart, right? So I'm showing you the American vowels, the vowels which are spoken in American English, in two varieties of American English. I'm showing you two varieties, right? The one is the Californian English, which is spoken in California, and the other is, English which is spoken in the North, right? In some cities of America. So the Californian English, you just can have an idea of the American vowels, the vowels of American English, which are given in this chart. And these are the vowels which are different than the BBC, vowels. We will talk about that later. But the point is that how these are different, right? How they have different formats, right? Like they have quite, higher value of F2, right? And F2, you may know that F2 is positively related to the frontness of the tongue, right? So they are producing vowels mostly from the front part of the tongue. So starting at almost like 1200 value, right, for F2. And then you can think about that they are making a diphthong here, right? And R, but R is not really low. It's somewhere like the mid-low position, and at the 700 F1, right? F1 is related to the height of the tongue. So in that case, you can think about these features. And this is basically the vowel, which is R color vowel. Let me zoom in so that you can think about this, right? This is basically, you can see the R coloring at the end of this R. So this is R, basically, R sound, which is central, R, but R is attached to it. So this is the R coloring, right? And then we can also discuss another variety of English, which is spoken in the northern cities. In the northern cities, like the Pittsburgh and Detroit. So this is the sample which is taken from Pittsburgh and Detroit cities from the North America, right? And you can see that how different it is, right? Like we had the idea from the Californian English that they started vowels from quite the front part of the tongue. But in this case, so this is one country, but within one country, you see the difference of the varieties of English is there, right? So they are starting somewhere around 900 of F2, right? So the place of articulation is different for these four sounds. So that's a big difference. And we are using the same chart using F1 and F2 as the common point of reference and the articulatory gestures. And this is, again, the R color is the similar sound, but its position is different, right? Its position is different in this language, which is spoken in the North cities of America, and the English, which is spoken in California. So this is a discussion by plotting on the basis of formants and then showing those, conventional descriptive articulatory, methods, we can compare varieties of English language with the help of these features.